because he was ready for Jake the Snake and Damian. And now they will not make their appearance at this match at this time, later date maybe. The Mouth of South may be quite a factor in the result of the upcoming match.
Who can tell? One thing I do know, being a wrestler or a former wrestler myself, is that you do make a game plan for one particular opponent, and when suddenly that opponent is switched at the last minute to somebody else, you sometimes find yourself a little up the creek. You don't have a game plan in mind. And I can imagine why Honky Tonk was looking a little flustered there.
You know, Lord Alfred, I look at Honky Tonk, man, and those suspenders bother me. I don't know that I would want to be wearing them and have somebody grab hold of them, stretch them, and then let them snap, you know? I'm just a thought. I don't know, you know?
Quite a pleasant thought.
Oh, well, this is the first time I've ever seen him wear suspenders, and he's... Well, he's stalling a little bit, a little showboating there, maybe. Billy Jack Haynes just standing there. He's just staring him down. The ringsiders jumping in back of us, jumping on the likes of Honky Tonk Man.
Billy Jack Haynes, as always, looking in just fantastic condition. Honky Tonk, of course, is also in great condition, although he doesn't have those fine muscular cuts that Haynes has. However, he is a strong and a very tough competitor.
Well, the Mouth of South went over alongside the ringsiders, got between the ringsiders and the Honky Tonk Man. Said, come on, let's get the ring now. Let's get it on.
Dick, the injury that Jake the Snake has is a most unusual injury. Apparently, where the muscle attaches itself in the back to the shoulder blade, all that has come apart and they've torn away, and it might be a long time healing.
Well, they wrap it and wait to see what happens.
Yes, the other thing, of course, is he's not going to be able to work out.
No, that's right. And that's deadly for an athlete. You got to work out.
Well, really, an upper body strength means so much in wrestling. I mean, you've got to have those firm limbs planted down, your legs. But if your leg is injured, at least you can work out on your upper body.
Yeah. Well, Honky Tonk Man in control of Billy Jack Haynes here, and working on the arm and the shoulder, adding pressure. Referee kneeling down saying, well, what about it? You submit a little early for that, but you never know. The pain might be great. You might have to.
You know, one thing I found with wrestlers when they go into the ring against Honky Tonk, they are liable to underestimate this man.
Well,
he really is a very competent wrestler, and if you watch all of his moves, you'll find that he can execute them with a lot of skill.
Well, he's a needler. Look, he's ruffling the hair of Billy Jack a little bit. Oh, turnabout here, huh? Payback time. Yanking on that arm and on the shoulder, and now blows to the shoulder over and over and over again. Billy Jack is handing back the pain he took a few minutes back. Drops the elbow. Nobody there.
Quick moving there by Haynes. Avoided that dropping elbow. Oh, God, did you hear that, Dick?
And the ultimate insult was Billy Jack mussing the hair of the Honky Tonk Man, who takes great pride in his coiffure.
There was a little test of strength there between the two of them. Billy Jack Haynes came out on top with that. Then there was a test of speed, and Billy Jack Haynes came out on top with that. So what does that leave the Honky Tonk Man?
Well, the fans are really on the Honky Tonk Man right now.
These chops are illegal. This ain't a kung fu karate match. He's pulling the man's hair, I'm telling you.
Well, you heard the Mouth of South telling his side of the story, more or less.
And I don't think we take too much notice of that. Pinch of salt, Jack.
Well, you can't take too seriously, in a sense, a guy who stands outside the ring. The guy inside the ring, he's the guy getting beat up. All right, they make contact against side headlock by the Honky Tonk Man of Billy Jack, and a smash to the face of the forehead. He said it was an open hand. Maybe it was, maybe it wasn't. He was pretty quick with it.
This match started off with Honky Tonk goading Billy Jack Haynes and trying to provoke him to lose his temper. And now I believe it's gone the other way. Billy Jack Haynes is trying to humiliate the Honky Tonk Man. Anything could happen here, Dick.
Honky Tonk's got a side headlock again, and he lays a knuckle sandwich on Billy Jack Haynes. I don't know how much longer this Haynes going to put up with this stuff, because that side headlock, he twists and turns, has his back to the referee, and does Honky Tonk Man, gives him a shot with a closed fist, and not the open hand, as he says. Referee's buying this so far.
Well, Honky Tonk will try and have his way with the referee and try and snatch any sort of crumbs he can get.
Here's that side headlock again.
Whoa! Nice block. Oh,
nice block. Couple of chops for himself. Billy Jack, back body drop. Oh, hello there.
Oh. High back drop by Haynes. Honky Tonk trying to slither out the ring there, but caught by a very alert Haynes.
Here's a snapmare takedown and a headlock by Billy Jack on Honky Tonk. Referee checking to make sure there's no chokehold. There isn't. Uh-huh. Billy Jack says, I've had enough of this in the past. I'm going to hand back his head to him.
Those powerful arms, the powerful arms of Haynes locked around Honky Tonk's head, and Honky Tonk not able to do much about it.
Well, I'll say one thing for the Honky Tonk Man. He's a gamer, trying like crazy to get to his feet, and has. But he's still in the bad part of town. Side headlock, the pressure still maintained by Billy Jack. Ah, a little hair pull. Referee, where are you? He's looking down. He should be looking up. Into the ropes. Dodging him. Oh, hello there. How do you like it, man?
Tremendous tackle. Moving at such a high rate of speed by Haynes.
Hey, Haynes says, no, you're not going away, man. Snapmare takedown again. Right on top of him. Maybe the beginning of a sleeper hold. Yeah, Honky Tonk Man, a little showboating there to the crowd when he should be paying attention to Billy Jack. And you saw what happened there. Oh, grabbing for the hair again.
I think also Honky Tonk was trying to shake the cobwebs out from that tremendous tackle by Haynes. Haynes showing the hallmark of a good wrestler, going back to a move that profited him before.
Well, you would know.
Honky Tonk Man upset. Colonel definitely upset. Who's that? Is that Miss Betty?
Just a moment. What?
Is that Miss Betty?
No, it's Tammy Faye.
Oh, okay. Because if it was Miss Betty, I want to give her a few words of advice.
Like what?
To stay away from the Vice Squad.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, she'll know exactly what I'm talking about. What an interesting matchup in a Philadelphia Spectrum. A beauty. We're going to be back with the exciting conclusion.
Her and that dancer are just good friends. There's nothing
Victor,
more to it.
Yes,
please. Nothing more
we'll
to it.
We'll be back in just a moment with the exciting conclusion of Billy Jack and the Honky Tonk Man. Stay with
just
us.
Just because he took off.
To explain something before we go back to our match, and that is that maybe the Honky Tonk Man has something really to gripe about, because he prepared himself for this particular matchup in the Philadelphia Spectrum to face Jake the Snake Roberts, and because of an injury that did not happen, and unbeknownst to him, he was thrown in there with Billy Jack Haynes, a very powerful individual.
Well, now we're going to go to
you don't have a clue where we are in the program or what we're doing or anything. This is just like a free time for you.
I have to conduct business 24 hours a day.
Your business is to be part of this program. Let's go back right now to Philadelphia.
What I was going
to
say.
Go ahead, say it.
We're going to go back to the match with
Lord Alfred, just very briefly, you've been out of wrestling just a fairly brief time, but the fact is, no longer active in wrestling in the ring, but certainly on the outside. What do you see with these new guys coming along? Their body conditioning, etc. They're getting bigger, tougher, I guess.
They really are.
Not that you guys weren't tough. But these guys are incredibly large and agile.
My wrestling weight was always 240 or thereabouts, but now it's not unusual to have men in that 260, 270 pound bracket moving with more speed than I possess then. And they have improved just so much.
There's a trip. All right. The mouth of South tripped Billy Jack when he was bounced off the ropes. Hello. Honky Tonk Man doing a flying knee to the side. A couple of forearm free, four blows to the back. Mouth of South made his presence felt.
The trip.
Oh. One, two. Uh-oh. Kicked out of it. Oh. Caught him with an clothesline him.
Billy Jack Haynes runs straight into that clothesline, That was a nice, very alert move by Honky Tonk Man. Of course, all that was afforded by the fact that his attention was diverted by Mouth of the South.
Well, I'll tell you, whether you like the Honky Tonk Man or not, you admit the guy knows what he's doing. Elbow smash the back of the head. Honky Tonk Man shouting his encouragement and direction. Knee lift, Billy Jack. Oh, outside the ring, down on the Spectrum floor.
Billy Jack Haynes went out backwards there, and now the Honky Tonk Man, he's showing how nasty he can be. And Billy, he's really showing off to the crowd here.
Billy Jack rolls back in the ring, but he looks like he can't breathe too well. Must have caught an elbow or a forearm right on the throat. Take him right in the ring corner.
Honky Tonk Man pushing Billy Jack Haynes back in to the corner post there.
Pushing the referee, man. That's a no-no.
Haynes, it seems to be really hurting badly. He must have taken a bad spill out of the ring just then. Honky Tonk Man taking his time. Very cool, very calm, very collected. A nice back elbow. Stuns Haynes. And now everything in his favor. The Honky Tonk Man saying he's going to break his neck. But well, it's certainly given him a lot of trouble.
Well, Haynes has taken a tremendous beating over the past 5 minutes or so. I mean, nonstop beating at the hands of a Honky Tonk Man. I don't know whether he can come back from all that. What do you think?
He has a lot of resilience, Dick. I've seen Haynes in a lot of trouble before, but he always seems to be able to dig down deep, come up with a little inner strength, and manage to snatch a victory. However, this might be something different with the Honky Tonk Man.
Well, Honky Tonk Man still distracted somewhat by the crowd. Billy Jack with a couple of elbows. Well, he ducks that roundhouse. Oh, fine takedown. One, two, kicks out. Maybe didn't have it. Takes a double chop to the neck. A series of blows to the back of the neck and the head.
That crossbody tackle by Haynes has certainly made the Honky Tonk Man erupt. He's no longer very complacent. He's lost his temper, and that might be the cause of him losing possibly this bout too.
Well, what's happening, the showboating by the Honky Tonk Man, in a sense you might say, is giving Billy Jack a breather. I don't know if that's actually helping him. He's taking him right off the top rope there. What, choking? Count of three. Pulls the rope, back goes Billy Jack, and a feeling and a smile on the face of the Honky Tonk Man, self-satisfactory. He loves it.
Honky Tonk Man taking full advantage of that five count on the ropes.
Body slam. I don't know. Oh, that does smart. Nobody home. The double chop coming up, but instead Billy Jack retaliates, going for the midsection on Honky Tonk Man. Honky Jack coming back. Tough dude. Smashing away Billy Jack, smashing at him. Got him locked in the corner. Whoa!
Reverse atomic drop there by Haynes has floored the Honky Tonk Man. Now the Honky Tonk Man is striving hard to get to his feet. He does. And he's going to give a back suplex to Billy Jack Haynes, who goes down heavily on the back of his head.
Haynes is favoring the back of his head. He and all, one, two, manages to kick out about 2.5. Honky Tonk's getting frustrated. All right, what now? Whoa, a little bit of boogaloo there. Whoa, back body drop by Billy Haynes on Honky Tonk.
I think Honky Tonk Man has taken this belt far too complacently because he's allowing Billy Jack Haynes to escape from all the hard positions he's been in. And I don't think he'll win this one either against Jack Haynes.
Maybe not. Haynes is upset. He's on a tear.
Tremendous back chop by Haynes. Two or three blows to the head. Throws in. Honky Tonk Man. Back elbow. Honky Tonk Man down and obviously stopped.
Well, Billy Jack now waiting. He's right on top of him. Little suplex coming up.
Just a tremendous twisting suplex there by Haynes, who held Honky Tonk Man up for at least 2 seconds before dropping it.
Haynes is up.
He's going for his Paul Nelson. This is his hold. One side.
Got away.
Mouth of the south there. A quick cover there by Billy Jack. Haynes, he's got it. A great cover there. A great move by Haynes. And the Honky Tonk Man found himself on the wrong end of that.
Well,
go to the ring for the official verdict.
Let's get it.
Here is your winner, Billy Jack Haynes.